Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our one-on-one session. Here are our speakers, Group Editorial Director, World Screen, Anna Carugati, and President, Univision Communications Incorporated, Cesar Conde.
Thank you. Even though it's lunchtime, thank you for joining us. It's much better to be here than being in line waiting for a table at a restaurant. Cesar doesn't need a whole lot of introduction. I can't imagine anybody in the room who isn't familiar with Univision. But why don't you just give us a very brief, it reaches how many homes? It's the number one broadcast Spanish language network in the United States. That's correct?
Sure, yes, Anna. And thank you for taking the time. Thank you to NAPTI for the invite, and it's good to see so many familiar faces. Yes, Univision Communications is the largest Spanish language media company here in the United States, focused on the Hispanic community and one of the largest diversified media companies in the world. And we're in three primary businesses, the TV business, the radio business, and the interactive business. And on the TV front, we have three primary television networks, Univision, Telefutura, and Galavision, and recently just added five new cable networks, so now we're a total of eight networks here at Univision, and our radio business is the largest Spanish language radio business here in the U.S., and our interactive platforms at Univision Interactive, also the leading platforms on the interactive and mobile front.
Okay, before we get into the conversation, I know that there is a video clip that will give a small introduction to what Univision is. If we could see that clip now, please. Just some data that I ran across. On a national level, Univision competes directly with the main broadcast networks, right? ABC, CBS, NBC, and Fox. The Univision's Los Angeles station, KMEX, is the number one station in the country, regardless of language. Before we get into programming and many other things, I think it's fair to say that Univision is perceived as more than television and online. It provides a sense of community to the Hispanic population in the United States. Can you speak to that a little bit so it sets the stage as to how the network is perceived in the U.S.?
Sure. No, thank you. Thank you, Anna. Look, at Univision, we try to start everything that we do, and I'm a big personal believer in this, in our mission, which is very straightforward. It's to inform, entertain, and empower the Latino community here in the United States. And on the first two, we get a report card every single day, and, you know, we try to do as good of a job as we can on informing and entertaining. On the empowerment piece, I think, is one that transcends really everything that we do. And I think it speaks to the role that we as a company, but I think it speaks broader to the growth of the Hispanic community here in the United States, and the importance of ensuring that we as a company, we as an industry, come together to make sure that we help empower this community to maximize its potential here in the United States. And that's something that we take, that responsibility we take very, very seriously. And fortunately, we have a lot of partners and a lot of friends that are also contributing to that.
Okay. Recently, Televisa invested, correct me if my numbers aren't right, $1.2 billion for a stake that will eventually reach 40% in Univision over time. I think that's correct.
Yes, $1.2 billion and change, yes.
Okay. Tell me what this investment brings to Univision. This is a lot of money to have. How do you what do you plan on doing with it?
Sure. Well, look, the Televisa partnership, the Televisa deal was clearly one of the corporate highlights for Univision in 2010. We are extraordinarily excited about it. I think this is one of those situations where 1 + 1 = 4 = 5. I think one of the nice things about this deal, about this partnership, is that it allows both companies to take advantage of opportunities that prior did not exist for any of the two companies, particularly on the digital space. And, you know, we have a long working relationship with our friends at Televisa, and I think with the explosive growth that we're seeing continuing here in the United States with the Latino community, we believe that these two companies partnering closer together and collaborating closer together can really be a force to be reckoned with here. And so we're looking forward to the years to come.
Now, I know that Televisa, aside from the stake, has been one of the primary suppliers of programming to Televisa. You also have Venevisión as a provider of programming. Does this Televisa stake impact your relationship with Venevisión in any way?
No, it does not. On the contrary, our friends at Televisa have been extraordinarily supportive of all of our partnerships that we have had in place and continue to invest in. Our Venevision partnership has been fantastic on a personal and professional level. We had a tremendous success with this year where we collaborated together on Eva Luna, which is one of our primetime novellas on air right now. It's been a tremendous success here in the United States, and we're starting to see some success for our friends at Venevision in other parts of the world. So we're very happy about that, and we're looking forward to other projects going forward as well.
About a year ago, you set up Televisa Studios.
Univision Studios.
Univision
no,
Studios.
Okay.
Sorry about that. Univision Studios, that's a big problem. What types of product? You already are very active in sports, very active in news, and in variety and general entertainment shows. What is the mission for the studios?
Sure. No, it's a good question. We have historically produced approximately 4,000 hours of original programming at Univision throughout the years. When we launched Univision Studios got a little over 12 months ago, so about a year ago, the impetus for it was we wanted to create a vehicle for Univision Communications that was our production / co-production arm that would allow us to customize programming more proactively and more opportunistically here for the Latino experience in the United States. And the objective of it is really to be the central point, to be the feeder of original productions, co-productions for our three TV networks, Univision, Telefutura, and Galavision, now our other five cable networks and growing cable portfolio, as well as for other platforms, including Univision Interactive and Univision Mobile. And so it's a central repository where we have invested not only in partnerships, but we have also invested in bringing on a great team, some folks that we just announced earlier this week to Univision Studios, to make sure that we're being proactive on that front as well.
Since you're going to be owning the content that you produce, do you have plans for international distribution of this product?
Yes, some of the content we do have rights to. Some of it we do not. We partner with. You know, clearly that is an opportunity for us. It's not an area that Univision has focused on tremendously historically, but absolutely it's one of those avenues that we want to begin to explore a little bit more.
Tell me a little bit about how you are programming this bouquet of channels that you now have. Are you looking to the Hispanic market? Not only is growing, but it's evolving. You have the earlier generations that grew up with Spanish in the homes only. You have the younger generations that are bilingual and more acculturated. Are you trying to reach the broader Latino community in the United States with your bouquet?
Yeah, well, it's absolutely a growing, and it's absolutely a demographic and a community that's diversifying. I think there's a few things that we try to look at this or approach this through through a certain lens. I think the first is our programming strategy. The way we approach programming is really a two-pronged approach. On the one hand, we have and will continue to tap in to the exclusive access to what we think is the best Spanish language programming in the world from all of our partners. And it's a position we're fortunate to be in, and it works very well. But second, and equally as important, we believe it's also important to complement that where appropriate with customized content for the Latino experience that fills in areas or genres that we may not have access to or that need to be produced here in the United States. And so I think the ability to have both of those things, the ability to have our cake and eat it too, essentially, has been a little bit at the root of the secret to our ability to continue to program successfully. You know, what that allows us to do is to really adapt and be nimble to the changing aspects of the marketplace. You know, as far as, you know, looking at our particular portfolio of networks, you know, we have a lot of different networks and we compete with so many people. Univision, you know, our aspiration, as, you know, we've been very vocal and very open about, is to be the number one network in this country, regardless of language, in 5 years. And today we're one of the top five networks in the country when you look at adults 18 to 49. But when you look at the younger demographic, which this is very important, we're in a stronger position, which we believe begins to foreshadow what is gonna be some of the landscape in the years to come. And so we're focused for the Univision network on those, on beating those four English language networks. And we've begun to close that gap, particularly in the last 12 months between the number five position and number four. Telefutura has been a great success for us over the last few years, and they compete very, very strongly in the Spanish language space versus all the other great providers and networks here in the United States. And, you know, we still have a ways to go, but we're very happy with the progress that's going there. And so across the portfolio of networks, what we really try to do is cross-program against that portfolio and make sure that we're trying to address the different interests that our community has and that our audience expects to get from all of the industry.
As the Univision, historically the Univision primetime schedule has focused a lot on telenovelas, which is what the viewers enjoy seeing at that time. But given the fact that there are more new entries into the market now, even though they're small, but they're providing different types of programming, is that in any way making you perhaps look at your program schedule in a different way, or are you sticking with what you've been doing successfully for all the years up to now?
Well, I can tell you, you are absolutely right. There's a lot of new entrants. It's a very competitive market, and we are very cognizant of that and are constantly watching what our friends in the business are doing. We have to, and that's a healthy dynamic. You know, in the same breath, I can tell you that the novella genre is a force of nature. And it has transcended generation, it transcends language, and it certainly transcends geography. And we see nothing but a continuation of that strength, and it certainly continues to fuel our prime time on Univision, the main network. Do we think that there are other genres that work and can complement that? Absolutely, and that's what we've tried to do in 2010, and hopefully we'll be able to build on that in 2011 to plug some of the holes that we see in other day parts and other parts of the grids of the network.
Given this very strong ratings position that you have in the market, tell me a little bit about your relationship with advertisers. It must be an easy one.
Well, I wish it was that easy to say. Look, we fortunately have had a good relationship with the ad community. I think the ad community over the years has begun to become more cognizant and understand better the opportunity that the Latino community has for them here in the United States. I think they've also become more cognizant of the opportunity that Spanish language media offers for them as an industry. You know, I'll give you some factoids that, you know, we have started to communicate, and I think it's helped bridge the lack of understanding of the importance and opportunity that we have here in the United States. Today, the United States Hispanic market, if it were a standalone consumer market, is the 14th largest consumer market in the world, has $1 trillion in purchasing power. And so when you speak to a Fortune 100 or Fortune 500 CEO or CMO, and put it in that context and ask them what type of investment they are making in consumer market number 15 that doesn't have the growth trajectory and doesn't have some of the underlying fundamentals that exist here in the United States in their backyard, I think it hits home. And you know, when you begin to extrapolate what we're going to look as a community here over the next 10, 20, and 30 years, any company, any organization that wants to be successful here in the United States and wants to invest in ensuring organic growth has to invest in the Hispanic community.
How has 2009 was a year that most of us would like to forget permanently.
That's right.
All indications are that the economy is improving, that advertising improving. How has Hispanic advertising been tracking compared to the general market? Is it moving faster? Is it still behind? How is it positioned?
Yeah, in general, and I think it varies by platform, television, radio, interactive. I think it varies by whether it's the national business or the local business. But overall, we have seen a nice rebound that is coming back. I think it's fueled by an increased understanding of our marketplace. I think it's fueled by the expectation of what are going to be the results to the 2010 census, which we should be seeing here in the next couple of months. I think all of that has added to it where we've seen a pretty healthy rebound. We are still not at where we were 3 years ago or the like, but we are absolutely heading in the right direction, and all the underlying fundamentals of our business, certainly at Univision, and I think across Spanish language media, are very, very strong. And so usually in this marketplace, in this industry, advertising dollars will follow the good ratings and the good fundamentals, and we certainly have the first part of that formula.
I hear from a lot of people in various aspects of the media business saying the industry is never going to go back to, you know, 2006, 2007, to those levels. Perhaps because of the growth of the Hispanic market, do you foresee that you may get back to where you were before and continue to grow?
We certainly hope so, and I think that's that we're all here with that expectation. Look, I believe we will. I really fundamentally believe, as I think everyone in our industry believes, that the 2000 census results are going to create a fundamental change and are going to really shift the conversation in many meetings and in many discussions when it comes to the future of the United States. And so, you know, again, any company, any organization that takes an honest, serious look at their desire to be successful in this country, across any industry, across any spectrum, has to look to this community as a driving force for growth.
Back in September, Univision ranked number one above, as we said before, the main English language broadcast networks. Tell me a little bit what fueled that kind of performance and how you're going to position yourself. And how many years did you say you wanted to be the number one broadcast network? What kind of programming is going to get you there?
Sure. Look, well, you know, fortunately we've had, you know, some victories. I think there's a few things I think we have to do. I think first is we have to reinforce this underdog mentality. We're not number one, we're number five. And we're focused on becoming number one. And so I think instilling that that hunger, instilling that focus amongst our team and across the organization, I think is fundamental for us. You know, I think second is flawless execution. It is an ambitious goal. It is an achievable goal, by the way, by objective measures. But it is an ambitious goal. We need to have absolutely near flawless execution over the next few years. And you know, I think the third thing that we have to do is we need to continue to push the envelope and be very forward leaning when it comes to the programming and developing content in our marketplace. We have to be able to pull from the best of all worlds. And, you know, do we have the perfect formula? I don't think so. But do we have a pretty good formula that we're constantly trying to tweak to adjust to this very fast-changing industry and fast-changing environment? I think we have a decent approach. And so, anyways, we're very much focused on those three things.
Now, viewers go primarily to the television set, but not only. We know that they're watching on their computers, on their iPads, on mobile devices. Tell me a little bit about how do you view new media in supporting the broadcast network?
Yeah, I think this is one of the big questions that we as an industry are facing. Look, the short answer is we think the interactive medium is fundamental to our short, medium and long-term growth at the company. We are fortunate to have the leading platform in Univision Interactive in this space for the Hispanic community. But you know, I think these mediums, these platforms are converging so quickly that you know, unless we continue to stay proactive, aggressive, and take some calculated risk, we run the risk of becoming irrelevant. And so we absolutely believe in the importance of new media. A few things to keep in mind. When you look at the Hispanic community here in the United States, we over-index when it comes to online and mobile services and mobile devices, particularly on the mobile side. We're very cognizant of that, particularly when it comes to the mobile side of the business. And so we believe very much that that is going to be a very good business for us down the road, and we are looking at it very seriously. You know, I will tell you in the same breath that we also have to make sure that our, you know, quote unquote, traditional, you know, TV platforms and individuals who grew up in that business understand and are comfortable with the new media environment and are thinking through a lens that they're no longer producing content simply for one screen. They are producing content across all screens and across all platforms. And again, I think we've made some tremendous inroads over the last 12 to 18 months on that front. I think we still, as a company, I think we still as an industry have a little bit to go. But you'll continue to see us experiment in this area, which I'm a big believer in. And you'll continue to see us you know, have some victories and also learn from some of our lessons.
At this point in time, what are you offering online and on mobile? Is it still clips, or are you offering full episodes? I imagine there are rights issues involved in all of that, but what can somebody get on their mobile device?
Sure. It's a much easier question to answer today than before December or January of this past year. We today offer, yes, short form content, all types of short form content from across the spectrum of our programming, but we also offer long form programming now, again from our programming as well as some of our partners. One of the new pieces of the Televisa transaction, by the way, gave us access to all of programming from Televisa, current and past, across all platforms, which we think is going to be important to begin to develop services and products that before were just not available to the Hispanic consumer here in the United States. And so we think that's important. I will tell you, one of the things that we have also tried to do is experiment with new interactive genres. We've experimented with a couple of what, you know, the industry has dubbed quote-unquote web novellas in the past, and we think that they have been great successes for us from an advertiser perspective as well as from a consumer perspective, and we're going to continue to experiment in that arena and make sure that, you know, we are also developing content for some of those mobile devices that some of the younger demographics are looking to consume.
We have a few minutes left.
Sure.
Talk to me a little bit about the news. Obviously, that's a huge, and sports, right? I mean, I know that in our household, I'm Italian, my husband is Brazilian. During the World Cup, we don't speak a whole lot, but we would come together and follow the World Cup on Univision as opposed to going to the English language because we thought the understanding of the game was better. That's personal opinion. However, sports and news are very important to your program schedule. Talk to me a little bit about that too.
This is a little bit of a biased audience, but that's okay.
That's okay.
Perfectly allowed. Look, for us, the areas of these genres are extraordinarily important to us. I go back to our mission, and we really do think about this every single day: inform, entertain, and empower. When it comes to informing, news is part of the DNA of our community. I think it is one of the most important contributions, one of the most important responsibilities that we have as an industry. And so providing the best cutting-edge information to our community, not only on the network level, on the local level, across platforms, is fundamental to what we do. And, you know, we believe that the way our community is beginning to consume media is changing. And so we have taken, for example, the news genre and consolidated under one head of news across all of Univision. And we want to make sure, again, that we are being proactive and leaning in and providing information to a community that historically did not have access to the same things. I will tell you, we have been, as an example, extraordinarily proactive in the political coverage. of not only this past election cycle, but the election cycle before. The Latino vote has become the swing vote in this country.
Absolutely.
And that has repercussions on a number of different fronts. But we believe, we have no opinion on what positions people take, but in the same breath, we absolutely believe that our community needs to be active, they need to be present, and they need to have their voice heard. And we're going to do everything within our power to make sure that they can make the best
informed
decision.
You were involved in registration drives, too, voter registration drives, and getting the word out. And certainly Univision, for the first time, was involved in the presidential debates.
Absolutely. In 2008, we made, I guess, a precedent-setting event where we had the first ever presidential debates, both for the Republican and Republican parties in Spanish language. And we think it was important, more than anything, to set the precedent that candidates now understand that it's not enough to talk about the Latino community. They need to speak directly to it, about the issues that matter most to them. And so, you know, the second phase, second evolution of that, you've begun to see in this 2010 congressional cycle, where we started having debates in some of the big state and federal elections, Florida, California, New York, Illinois, Texas, and the like. And candidates, again, are waking up to the importance of speaking directly to this community. I think 2012, we'll see a continuation of that trend, and we're happy about the role we're playing there. Sports is another genre, to pick up on your point, that's extraordinarily important for our community as a passion point, and we equally believe that we have to be proactive and lean forward. We've been fortunate in that we've picked up some rights to some important properties such as the Mexican national team and other soccer and other sports. But we also want to make sure that we're diversifying the type of stuff that we're looking at. You know, we're going to be participating in the Super Bowl this year with a bunch of events with the NFL. And so, you know, these are areas that, you know, we need to begin to do more work in. But news and sports will continue to be anchors of what we do, and we'll continue to invest in them.
And finally, what growth areas do you see as you look out? When I used to ask this question, it used to be, what do you see in 5 years? I think now it's hard to tell in 5 months, but I'll say in 12 months. What do you see? Where are your growth opportunities?
Look, I think we are, you know, clearly we are focused on monetizing some of these great results that we as a company and we as an industry are having. And so monetizing better is, we think, is a big, big opportunity for us. And that census, we hope, is going to be able to contribute to that. I think, too, we have to continue to accelerate the integration of new media into our core business. I'm a big believer that this convergence that we are seeing is going to happen faster than what we expect, and probably in a different way than we expect. And three is we're going to continue to invest in trying to hire the best talent in front and behind the camera to make sure that we're continuing to fuel that those creative juices, those competitive juices that we need to be to, you know, continue our leadership position and hopefully build on it in the years to come.
All right. Thank you, Cesar, very much.
Anna, thank you.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.